and blot out all mine iniquities. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Heavenly Father, hear my prayer for the sake of thy Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Those whom I love, I reprove and chasten. So be zealous and repent. Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come in to him and eat with him, and he with me. He who conquers, I will grant him to sit with me on my throne, as I myself conquered and sat down with my Father on his throne.
Thank you.
A reading from the 13th chapter of Romans. Besides this, you know what hour it is, how it is full time now for you to wake from sleep. For salvation is nearer to us now than when we first believed. The night is far gone, the day is at hand. Let us then cast off the works of darkness and put on the armor of light. Let us conduct ourselves becomingly as in the day, not in reveling and drunkenness, not in debauchery and licentiousness, not in quarreling and jealousy, but put on the Lord Jesus Christ and make no provision for the flesh to gratify its desires.
Shine with the brightness of the true light. Grant, we beseech thee, that as we have known on earth the mysteries of that light, we may also come to the fullness of its joys in heaven. Through the same our Lord Jesus Christ, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, ever one God, world without end. Amen.
Thank you.
reading from the 23rd chapter of Luke. And when they came to the place which is called the Skull, there they crucified him, and the criminals, one on the right and one on the left. And Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do." And they cast lots to divide his garments. It was now about the sixth hour, and there was darkness over the whole land until the ninth hour, while the sun's light failed. And the curtain of the temple was torn in two. Then Jesus, crying with a loud voice, said, "Father, into thy hands I commit my spirit." And having said this, he breathed his last.
Be seated. Some words from Edgar Carlson. He to whom men had done their worst when they nailed him to the tree had done his best for man. He came back to claim unworthy disciples as his own, without a word of rebuke or censure. He gave them a gospel of forgiveness to be preached to all the world. The God who was incarnate in Jesus Christ is love. The incontrovertible proof of it is the death and resurrection of our Lord. It is this absolute and unconditioned love of God which could take all the evil that there is in the world into itself and bear it in place of those who should have borne it. It is this that is the good news. There is nothing that men can do to God that they did not do to him when they nailed Jesus Christ to the cross. And he came back to forgive them. This is the rock foundation upon which our faith is fixed.
Amen.
But Peter, standing with the 11, lifted up his voice and addressed them. Men of Judea and all who dwell in Jerusalem, let this be known to you and give ear to my words. For these men are not drunk, as you suppose, since it is only the third hour of the day. But this is what was spoken by the prophet Joel. And in the last days it shall be, God declares, that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. Yea, and on my men servants and my maid servants in those days I will pour out my spirit, and they shall prophesy.
This day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Bow your hearts to God, and receive the benediction. The Lord bless thee and keep thee. The Lord make his face shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee. The Lord lift up his countenance upon thee and give thee peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
seated and remain seated for the host.